in incredibly quick to CAW, so to stand tall, as to what the level of commitment is required for the workforce. I know that Marcel is here.
Where's Marcel?
The last Marcel. I think Marcel and the team up in Windsor have done a phenomenal job of building the type of work environment that we think is essential to move the industrial agenda forward. And I think that, as long as those conditions are maintained, you need to understand the decision to move on Windsor now was made for a variety of reasons, including the fact that we ran out of time. There was a point in time in the cycle of the architecture that you've got to make the call and you've got to replace it. And so the runway was finished, and the noise surrounding this announcement became so distasteful that FIA decided to put it on. It has an obligation to the people who work in Windsor to make sure that we move the agenda forward. I'm shocked, unfortunately, I'm surprised by the lack of quality and the response that we received from some parts of the Canadian context. I think some of the comments, apart from the fact that the number that has been bandied around as being the assistance number, is so far out of reach that we're talking about two different words.
What was your ask then?
It doesn't matter what I asked. The issue is that the numbers that you bandied around and the number that was offered were diametrically opposed. We'll leave it at the facts, because Chrysler is no longer interested in the matter, so it's over. And secondly, the language that was being used to refer to what I consider to be an accomplished industrial policy development was something that was not to our liking. I repeat here, and I make it public, that Chrysler is not in the business of accepting handouts. And if provincial and federal authorities in Canada think that that's the way in which you attract foreign investment, I think you are in for a big shock.
Mr. Plunge, between you, Mr. Marks,
would like to hear?
No, it doesn't matter. It's gone.
Mr. Marks,
but it's gone. So
3 to 5 years from now, next
cycle. I think we need to ignore this issue, because that chapter is closed. Fiat Chrysler has moved it on. So the agenda, from my standpoint, is complete.
But 3 to 5 years from now?
No, but 3 to 5 years, I'm not a policymaker. And I was incredibly clear, both in the letter that we sent to the Prime Minister and to the Premier, to the press release, the position, and to the letter that I sent over to the Global Mail, I think it was the Global Mail, in response to this notional assessment of what we were trying to
do. Mr. Marchione.
I think for the benefit of the people inside Chrysler Canada, for the benefit of the people of Windsor, we need to stop our problems. You're now doing more damage to them than you actually can.
Mr. Marchione, I just need to be clear, because I had a hard time hearing you right at the beginning. As far as the Windsor minivan investment, is it $2 billion?
No, look, you keep on pushing for numbers and I keep on telling you that I won't tell you. This is a private capital investment decision by Chrysler Canada, and it will make it on its own terms. It's asking nothing of anybody. And it's about time that you stop interfering in the capital expenditure profile. That's our decision. It's not yours, it's not the press's, and it doesn't depend on government.
Is it still going to get a brand new platform?
It's our decision. The only thing we said is that we would invest in the new minivan architecture.